Dave Palumbo with an RX Muscle rant. Guys, today we're going to talk about how to get a great stage tan. You know, you guys today are so lazy. You go to the show, you get spray tan, you get up on stage, and you do your thing. Back in the 90s and way before that, we had to paint on this tan. You know, it was started as Dioderm, went to Pro Tan. Then we had some more options with Jan Tanner, and nowadays it's liquid sun rays. But, you know, the bottom line was it didn't just happen instantly. You had to spend days. You would go, if you had a show on Saturday, on Thursday, you'd put the tan on. Friday, you'd put it on all day long, night. You touch it up on Saturday, and it was this brush, and it smelled, and you'd be screaming at your partner, whoever it is, hey, get my back, you missed a spot, and it's streaking, and it was a crazy, stressful situation. But the key was proper preparation. If you didn't prep and have your skin ready prior to doing that color, it looked like crap. And that's the same thing for today. I mean, nowadays you can get spray tan, and if you're lucky, everything will look great. But if you know, if you bang into a wall and you push the tan off, if you don't have a base tan under there, it looks terrible. So people always ask me, Dave, what's the right process to get a great tan on stage? And the key is to have the darkest possible skin color prior to putting the tan on. Why do you think black people and dark-skinned, you know, Arabic people have the best tans on stage? Because they have the best base tan prior to putting the coloring on. That's the key. So whether it's if it's summer and you want to tan outside, and look, during the summer months, I would tan literally 10-15 minutes. I'd lay outside 10-15 minutes on one side, and flip over 10-15 minutes on the other side. And that's all it took. You didn't need to get burned every single time you went out there. If you did it, you know, 5 days a week, you had a great base tan. If you don't have the time to lay outside because you have a real job, if it's winter or it's not sunny enough, it's too cold, then you go to a tanning bed. You know, whether you do a lay down one, a standing one, you only got to go in for, like, nowadays these standing ones, it's like what, 3 minutes, 5 minutes? I don't know. They're so quick. There's no excuse. You know, and I used to go tanning in a tanning, you know, bed or a stand up for like, you know, at least 3 to 5 times a week, you know, especially as the last, you know, 4 to 6 weeks of the show came up. So I would have a really good base tan. You know, then later in my career, they actually came out with that peptide Melanotan 2. And I was using that. Melanotan 2 is a peptide that will actually cause your skin to produce pigment. You know, it actually darkens your skin. It gives you a perfect tan. And the great thing about Melanotan 2 is it darkens everything. Underarms, you know, genitalia, everything gets darker. And so that's another really good option. Now, some people get a little bit of darkening of their freckles. They don't even know they have freckles and they come out because it darkens everything. And if you do too much of it, you actually can turn purple. You know, because you don't want to look like that. You don't want your lips turning purple and stuff like that. So you don't want to go too crazy with it. I always found that, you know, if you had a 5 milligram vial and you mixed, you know, 2 mLs of water in there and you did 5 little units on an insulin pen, you know, before bed, you know, for 2 weeks straight, you get your color you want. And the interesting thing is when you have melanotan, you don't need to tan in a tanning bed or outside, but if you do, it speeds it up. After 2 weeks, usually you get a pretty good base color, and then you can do it maybe once or twice a week just to maintain. And once again, it's a very small amount. If you do too much melanotan too, you get nauseous, okay? You just get, you know, really queasy. You get like this flushed feeling. And melanotan too has a Viagra-like effect on it too. So I found that the best thing to do would be do it right before bed, okay? Because you get like that flushed feeling. It goes away after like 5 or so minutes. You're laying in bed, you go right to sleep. And you kind of sleep through the slight, minuscule nausea feeling. Now, if you do too much of it, the nausea feeling is really bad and it's not fun. It's not a nice feeling. So less is better over a longer period of time. And then once again, maintenance. If you tan, once again, with the melanotan, you will get a darker color. That's the wonderful thing. I liked it also because it would make the scalp of my head darker too. So it didn't look like I was so sparse haired. But you know, these are things you have to do. You have to have a very good base tan leading into that last week before your competition. Then when you get spray tan, it doesn't even matter what you use. You can use Pro Tan, you can use liquid sun rays, you can use Jan Tanner. They are all gonna give you a good tan. If you are pale, pasty white, now you're throwing the dice. It's a crapshoot. All these companies are good, But, you know, sometimes it doesn't agree with your pH of your skin. Sometimes it doesn't cover well. I think you're crazy to go to a show and be pale white and just say, okay, spray tan me, let's see how it works out. I want backup. I want to know, you know, when they paint your walls of your house, they put a primer coat on there first. There's a reason. So that if there's a little spot missing, you're not gonna, it's not gonna stick through. You know, and the paint will hold better. I remember when we had, I think in my dad's house, he had some, like a weird colored paint when we moved into the house. They had a primer before they put white paint on it, or you would have seen the dark color through it. Same thing, it's in reverse. If you have white skin and you paint on a dark, you know, tan, okay, and it's not perfect, okay, and it gets smudged a little, you're gonna see the white come through. If it runs because you're nervous and you're sweating, it's gonna come off and you're gonna see it. You're not gonna have a base color underneath. You gotta have a base tan. That is the key. You are going, spending money on diet, supplements, okay, performance enhancing stuff. You're entering the show for God knows how much money. It could be $350 if you're doing nationals. You're paying an NPC card. You're flying there. You're staying in a hotel. You're paying for food and taxis and everything else that goes along with the whole process. And then you're not going to take care of your tan? It's silly. You're putting so much time and effort and money into this. Don't skimp. Go sit in a tanning bed. Now, I know people that can't tan because they're prone to skin cancer, or they've had skin cancer, or they just burn. Then you can use melanotan too. It's very readily available. Okay, it's safe. There's no side effects aside from, like I said, some freckling. And the funny thing is, if you get little freckles, they go away when you stop the stuff. It's just a pigment. You're just darkening all the pigment on your body. And if you have a little light freckle, it's going to be slightly darker than the rest of your body. But I used melanotan for years, and I had a bunch of freckles, and they just disappeared when I stopped taking it, and the tan faded. So get a base tan, then get sprayed. Whatever company you happen to want to use, it's up to you. I really like liquid sun rays in terms of instant color. For color that's maybe going to develop over a couple days, I like Pro-Tan. They have a nice base of development. Pro-Tan is interesting because Pro-Tan isn't instant. It's you spray it on, and it gets darker and darker, you know, as it sits on your skin. They all do to some degree, but I know Pro-Tan really, if you like to have something where you do in advance and let it develop, then that's a way to go. Liquid Sunray is very good instant color. Jantana also very good instant color, depending on who's applying it. So do your research, you know, see who's going to be at the show. Set up your tanning appointment ahead of time. Make sure you prep your skin according to the way they tell you to do it, if you have to, like, you know, loofah and stuff like that. But the key is, get a base tan. Don't show up pasty white. I'm Dave Palumbo with an RX Muscle Rant.